Welcome to my channel. My name is Mildred Lee and I have two paper block pads that I've mentioned in the previous vlogs, but I forgot to tell you. Let me grab my mixer stand. I forgot to tell you that I saw in the store, I don't know if I can show you. Yeah, so like this, I believe I saw this one. I don't know if the other ones die cut, because this is die cut. I know for sure that there are other illustrations in these die cuts. They are in also in sticker form, which I did not grab them because I didn't know because I was in a rush in shopping in 20 minutes. But I saw, like I said, at Elise Dingen, a Dutch YouTuber, that this is an old one. This is a very old sticker sheet where you can, this is the back and this is the front. And what I mean is these, what I talked about, just about, there are sticker forms, the same illustration in the die cut, in this kind of setup. So these stickers, these tall, large stickers, where you get two sheets of them. Well, you can choose, like, I'm gonna go for these paper pads or paper blocks and not for the stickers. Or you can just decide, hey, I want to go for the stickers that I've shown you and for the paper blocks, both of them. But I chose for the blocks only. So I've mentioned wrong price. So these paper blocks, what are they priced? Here, and I don't know anymore. 1.79 euro per block, and these paper writing block, the writing paper and the envelopes are 1.89 euro, because I only bought two of them, so they are here, the two prices. So that's that. I'm gonna put those in the bag. I don't know for sure if I told the wrong price in part 1, 2, and 3, but I thought by myself, wait a minute, I think I did the wrong price. So let's see. Here it says, here where my thumb is, bullet journal scrapbook cutouts, 2.49 euro. I only bought two, these two. And I believe there was the back lining, the color, I found there was in black, and there was another color. So there must be, I think, in total of 4, but there is a possibility there's actually a total of 6. But I couldn't find the other two. I only found 4 of these. And from the 4 of these bullet journal scrapbooking, I only chose 2. So there you got the cheetah one and the flower one. So let's start with the cheetah one. So you open it and you get this illustration. So then you get, oh yeah, I have to tell you. So this scrapbooking thing here in front of you, they are double-sided. So in case you cut, you have to cut it out with a pair of scissors. They are not already cut for you, like as an in a die cut paper pad. So you have to cut it with yourself with a pair of scissors. So if you like here the illustration, you lose the back side. But now apparently there is, I don't know if you can see, it's dotted, gray dots. So I think they have listened. The complaints of people that one side, it's printed and then you cut it and then you lose the other side. But I don't want to be happy, so let's see. So you get a couple of these dotted sheets. Then you get this one. Oh, they have listened. So every illustrations on the sheet, you get on the back side the bullet journal with the dots. Oh, they. So what does that mean? Because I know for a fact that there's a bunch of sheets, they were on both sides illustrations, and then in the middle was the center part. I don't know how much that was, the dot bullet journal, the dot sheets, and then on the other side the entire is the illustration sheet. So now it's very different. I think they have listened to complaints of people. And look at the balloon dog in pink this time. I remember there was, like I told you, with this sticker pack, I saw there was also a balloon dog. So I know for sure that there is. So now that the question is, am I tempted to still buy the stickers, the sticker pack? Because I know for sure that in the past, when they do, when there was not things like this, bullet journal scrapping book, the stickers were like, there was at least 10 different kind of themes on the stickers. So now we have the paper writing block and a paper pad and this bullet journal scrapping book. It's all connected, because I see the drawings or illustrations like, hey, it is familiar. I've seen it on someone else's videos of Dutch YouTubers talking about crafts. So, that's the thing. So now I'm happy that they have finally listened to people. But now I'm not sure with the old bullet journal scrapping book, scrapbooking, sorry. It looks like there were more illustrations, but I'm not sure if it is. If it's now all divided, completely divided. So if I like these illustrations to make a snail mail or something for pen pal, then I just simply can cut it, because I don't lose the, on the other side, this side, illustrations. So I'm not sure if I it will lose some sheets with illustrations. So there's a lot of nice I'm gonna take you off the stand drawings, and then let's see. Did I miss something? No. Then you got this, a beautiful print. Well, you can take it as a print and put it on your, mount it on your wall. And this one, I skip because I can feel already how far I can go. So here, as you can see, there are threads. You simply cut with your pair of scissors all of these threads, so you can simply lift the page out. Wait, I can show it to you. I can do it right now. Oh, you can use the X-Acto knife or a pair of scissors. Well, if you're scared with the X-Acto knife because it's sharp, you can simply use a pair of scissors. But if you're brave, you're like, hey, I'm not scared, using the X-Acto knife or the cutting crafting knife. But it's difficult to reach the inside of the back. We call this the back of the book. then I'd rather go for the I'm looking for my X-Acto knife. Oh, here it is. Easy peasy. Oh, I didn't. Apparently, I didn't retract it. So, luckily, I didn't do something stupid. So, like this. So, you can just cut the threads out and then lift it carefully, the sheet out of the book, like this, you see, and then you can finally use your pair of scissors and cut it nicely. So that's what you can do here. You can use it as a print or for snail mail, and this you can make because it's horizontally, you can turn it like this and cut it with your paper cutting machine or your pair of scissors and punch a hole in there so you can make bookmarks, because in the back it's just simply a dotted page, as in bullet journal page. It's on the other side the same, but luckily with this book they do it in batches. So here you can take it out, but then on the other side, like, let's see if I can show you. No. Here, you have to cut it again with your X-Acto knife to cut the threads out and lift in, if you want to use these pages for, like I said, bullet journal, snail mail, or pen pal, you can lift it out once you've cut the thread. So it's not like once, like here, I've cut the thread and then suddenly everything falls out. No, it's done in batches, so you can leave it like this and just cut only the parts that you want to lift it out. So, or simply use your ruler and then do it precisely. But then I'm scared that if you cut a bit slanted or not straight, you will cut onto your next page. Well, in this case it doesn't matter, it's just a bullet journal paper with dots. But if you have some papers, like, let's see if there's one extra. Oh, they did not do like a bunch of the illustration sheets all together, like a couple of, oh here, sorry, I didn't show you. So this is with quotes, or you can, yeah, you have to do each letter fussy cutting with your pair of scissors. So you have this. Oh, look at this illustration, look at this forest team, this is the jungle team. I know it is different kind, two different kinds of themes. Look at this, nice, the banner. So you can draw the banner yourself, but here they have printed it for you, so it's easily. Oh, sorry, I got these to do and my goals page, this one. This one, this is a weekly planner. I think that's new, the weekly planner, but I'm not sure. Look at that, beautiful. Oh yeah, you see, I think I know for sure now, this book, because I have the first season, this is I think the second season. On the first season, there was a bunch of illustrations on this side, and a bunch of bullet journal dots, and then a bunch of here illustrations. I believe, because they had to listen to the customers, hey, we don't like it, that when you love the illustration on the front and you put illustration on the back on the same page, that you will lose the favorite picture that is on the page. You have to decide, like, hey, it's the one or the other. And now it's like, I think it's compromised. I think it's lesser illustrated sheets and more bullet journal paper. I think some people complained like there's less bullet journal paper. But this is my thought process. I'm not gonna make it larger than it is, this video, because this video is already 4 parts. That's ridiculous. I tried to do it like in 1 or 2 parts. But I think there is this thing that they compromise it by using less sheets of pictures and more bullet journal pages. But hey, if I want to be sure, I have to count every pages and sheets of illustrations and the other, the bullet journal papers. So I don't want to do it now. So let's go to the next one. That's the bullet journal scrapbooking with flowers. So I saw this, this eucalyptus, and I thought by myself, I want this one. So because I decided I'm on a budget, I couldn't take all 4 of them, and I don't like the other 2. It's not my favorite or my style, so I didn't take that one. So I chose for this one based on eucalyptus. So luckily I did look further on. So this is not dotted, it has graphs. So you know, for math, these squared lines. So I mean squared lines, horizontal and vertical lines. So I'm gonna look for these illustrations. So these are the illustrated ones. And next, look at that, vintage color, nice. Oh, it looks like it's for the first time that I've seen, but I remember I saw this already, because I remember the owl. I'm like, what? Why am I acting so surprised? I already saw that in the store. So this is the other one. This is the next one. Oh, nice. Way to go. And here, photography. I've missed. Yeah. Wow, they have gone. The first season of the bullet journals were great, and that's why I took like all 4 of them. But this new season, the next one, they are also exquisite. So you got this. Oh, look at this. This I didn't see. The Buddha. I didn't know about the Buddha. So you got the mandala. Here, the mandala. And the dream catcher in the corner. Oops. Green. So the dominant color is green, and then blue. So it's very, it's not like the same color, it's diverse. Look, then you got this color. I don't know how you name this color. It's not rust, it's not cherry. It's not brown. And then you got this one. I'm so in awe. There is a lot you can just use it for. So if you are a bit lazy, with your bullet journal. Normally you write and draw the spaces for the whole week in 2 pages. And now you can, they are just printed out for you. All you have to do is take the whole sheet or page and then stick it on your bullet journal. If your bullet journal is the same size as this bullet journal scrapbooking. But you can also, well, cut it in parts. So you can divide the, here it's 9 spaces, because these last two are notes. You can divide it in 2 pages on the bullet journal. And then fill it in other things, like pictures or something like that. But that is so genius. I said so already with the season 1. But look, weekly planner. So you get 2 pieces. The other book, I think it had only 1. Now you have 2. And oh, this is dirt. Apparently someone, or it is a misprint, or someone stepped over it. But I think it's a misprint. It doesn't seem like it's someone's shoe was, someone's feet stepped on it. So I don't think that. And then this. This is the birthday theme. And then this one. Look at that. The black and white picture. And then here in the center, the forest animals. And then you have the fashion or sewing or knitting things. Elements. Have I mentioned that I love this kind of paper? I really, really love this kind of paper. I'm not so interested in lined paper. Oh, look at the lovely poppies. Look at that, look at that. Let's see what's the next one. Look at that. I really like this. Even though I believe because the customer listened to the because the deco time, is it deco time? Who made this? It does. Oh, Craft Universe. Craft Universe. I think they listened to the customers, like, hey, we don't like so and so and so. I believe sincerely that it's compromised. We've lost some pages of illustrations. I believe that. Then you got this one. So what you can do is cut this out and cut this piece out carefully with X-Acto knife, and I don't know if you can see it, and this kind of mat. So if you first cut the threads, so you can lift this page out, and then use your ruler and the X-Acto knife, cut a square out, so you can use the picture for something, to make a picture frame or something for the bullet journal or for the envelope, and then cut strips of paper, because you need, these are the months, so January, February, March. And then use it for your bullet journal. So you have a lot of ideas to use every piece of paper or sheets or pages. It's so nice. It's diverse. You can use for everything. So here is 3 kinds of illustrations. All you have to do is cut them with your pair of scissors. Or if you're lazy, you can use a paper cutting machine. I'm sorry. Paper cutting machine or a guillotine, and then put a hole in there to make a bookmark. And like I said, these prints are beautiful to make a picture frame out of it. I think I missed one. Did I miss one? Yes. I believe this is the last one, the blue one. Is there another one here? The end? Yes, there is. Look, the ant has notes. So, I'm happy because I love this print. I can cut the thread and lift the paper out and then use this print. Let's see if the front is also like that. No, the thread is not here, but it doesn't matter. The thread is a little bit on this side here. And I can lift the paper out or just use simply, because it's the first page of the book, I can simply use the X-Acto knife and then cut it out. There's nothing kind of paper that I am able to destroy, because I can follow the line here and simply cut it open. So I have two piece of paper with this eucalyptus. Oh, I love it. I'm gonna love it. Okay, so here is the two of the four that I know of bullet journal scrapbooking, and it's for the price of €2.49. Now I have a third one in the corner, and that's something else. I'm gonna put this in the bag. Okay, so this is something else. This is called My Bullet Journal. Let's see if I can find it. It's here at my side. Oh, okay. Okay, it's a bit difficult to get it out. Okay. I have it. So I have a bullet journal. That is the black paper edition. So these are the pages that I've covered or decorated. But I'm gonna use the close up. So this is the black paper version, but this is something completely different. It's the same as this one. I'm gonna put you in the stand. So this is the elastic band to hold the complete book together. And you get two ribbons, like this one. You get two ribbons, but this is a completely different kind of bullet journal because there are three types of paper, three in one. You have this paper, this paper, this paper, and I will take the paper out so you can see the illustration. Look, they have even made a hole that was not in the other ones. They have even made a hole to shape it out of the time loop, pen loop. Normally it was just one hole, one piece of paper with no holes in it. This is the first time I've seen a hole. So, let's see. I'm gonna open it. This is the illustration of this bullet journal. There were, I believe I saw two or three other of these, but those were normal bullet journal. This is the one of a kind that has three kinds of paper. So I'm gonna show it to you. So you get this little booklet. It says My Bullet Journal. I don't know why they've cut it so dumb. It has really cut into the letters, instruction book. Or they should have put the letters a bit up, the words a bit up. So you can get these things, examples. So this is actually the first page. I've double grabbed it. So it looks like renovating things, you know, with a brush, a big brush to paint your walls. And here the measuring thing. So this is actually page 2, page 3, 4. These are all examples. If you don't know how to bullet journal, they will show you, hey, these are examples. So you can do it like this. Or maybe if you want different like that. But these are examples. So then you cut. Oh, I think it's better to take it out of the stand. So this kind of paper, so it has dots, and then I will shift to you. As you can see, it's three kinds of paper. So I'm gonna go to the next one. like this. So this is the previous paper, and this is the next paper. This is the craft paper, but the craft paper also had dots. Isn't that genius? So I'm gonna shift. Let's see. Shift to the next batch. So now you got this kind of paper, craft paper, and the black paper. And the black paper has light blue dots. This one has craft paper with beige dots. You have this, it's not yellow paper, but yellowish. I don't know what kind of paper you have to mention this. This has darker beige dots. So, as you see, these are the two ribbons. So, they had on the shelves the normal bullet journal. Then I didn't see this one as a repeat, but I saw this special one, and I thought to myself, I have to have this because I'm not interested in the bullet in the third season. I think it's the third season. I'm not interested in the normal bullet journal, because I have loads of those, and I have this black paper version. Right, black paper version, and I'm so happy with this one, and I am totally enthusiastic with this kind of bullet journal, because it's hard for me to bullet journal on time regularly. So for me, it's more like, you know how I work. So I'm looking for the space. Where's the space? I know it's in here. I can feel it. Yes, there. And I can see it. I missed another one. So here. No. Oh. That's the thing. Look, there is some glue here, but it covers the threads. Oh, they are smart, because I like to do sometimes with the notebooks, if I'm very, very interested in the notebooks, like, hey, cut the threads up. I don't know if you can see it. I'm going to take it out of the stand. There. There's threads. You see, I love to cut the threads up with an X-Acto knife and simply lift the page up to use the paper without ruining the next page in front or back of the page that I've taken it out. So they are smart to put dots of glue in there. Oh, but why would they do something like this? Let's see if they do it with the yellowish paper. If they do it the same thing like that with using the glue. I can see already. Oh no. Yeah, the same thing. Why did they do it? They put some glue in there. Here. I can see the thread already here. I'm not happy with that. Oh, I wanted to lift the paper off. Because this kind of paper is, I think, 80 GSM. No. Yeah. I think it's a little bit thicker than the copy paper machine. Copy paper, you know, the A4? I think it's a little bit, this one is a little bit thicker. Well, it doesn't matter. I love this bullet journal. Three types of paper. Who wouldn't want it? So, here are the key things. And then it says bullet journal. Oh, there it is. 96 pages and it is 19 GSM. You see, I know my paper. Okay, the last thing that I want to talk about is let's see, faces. Yeah. So I was on the previous vlog, part three, I was talking about the faces, but I was suddenly cut off. So what I wanted to tell you about, the price of this one, the cylinder one, is €1.69. This one was on sale wall. This is a water carafe, €1.49. Yeah, can you believe it? It's weird, don't you think? It's the same size, it's only tapered here. Okay, the mouth is here smaller than this one, but the actual shape is the same as this one. Okay, it's tapered down here, but it's practically almost the same. So I don't understand why this is €1.69, this one is €1.49. This is for to put water, if you're having a picnic, a barbecue, put water, fruit, mint, ice cubes, water. This one is more for flowers.